Hi. Straight from Yuma. Mariana, say hi.
Hi.
Yeah. You guys, we got friends today. Riley?
Madison.
Madison. Olive?
Mariana.
What's the rule about the house?
Friends are always welcome.
Friends are always welcome. Yeah? Did you have fun?
Yeah.
Okay. So, Mariana was in Zuni, third grade with you, and moved to Yuma. Sad. Mm-hmm. You were sad. You were very sad. Yeah.
In sixth grade, though.
Yeah. So, luckily, you guys didn't touch. And she's here visiting us.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Did it turn off?
No.
Mm-hmm.
It's still recording.
Hey, these two are great. So, we went on a run and a bike ride. Mm-hmm. And I didn't realize until the end, these two knuckleheads were on FaceTime the entire time. Yeah. And it is hilarious. Yeah. So we had some fun in the pool. Did you have a good time? Yeah. And then when I saw you at the mall, I had not seen you for 2 years.
I didn't even recognize you.
I say three.
Oh.
You don't recognize?
I didn't even know who you were.
Oh, wow.
Oh, that's great. Charming. Yeah. It is funny, though. Tell me, remember how you remembered me?
Yeah. Oh. So, I remember you. Because you put a little Lego man on top of the board, teacher's board.
Yeah. How long did it stay there?
Whole year?
Was it the whole year? So we snuck in. Remember, we snuck in and we were drawing on the board. Was it parent teacher? Or
yes.
Yes. Yeah. And we put the little Lego guy up on poor Miss Harmon's board.
And he, like, never
Ms.
moved.
Miss Harmon?
Yeah. What did you guys use the Legos for? Was it for counting? Or
for free time?
Yeah, free time.
Okay.
So we spent the first part of the week really hammering footwork. This particular drill was set for their backhand. Coach Lizzie tossed them just a little bit hard here, but they're getting better and they're getting it. Here's Haley. Says she has never played before. Don't 100% believe her. She's pretty good. And here's Peyton. Peyton is awesome. We started this drill last week, just one of them in the box, fly balls, rapid fire, and stepped it up this week with two of them in the box. So this drill is to work on tracking balls and communication. These were two of my veteran players, and unfortunately right here, Mariah gets called off. It takes her right off the table. Mariah is a champ kill. Did not miss a beat, got right back in there, and look at her dancing. I had drawn this one up as a quarterback drill. Our two captains are sitting back here, tossing out fly balls to help with the girls tracking. It didn't quite go as planned, and it's kind of morphed into me throwing it to them. And they love the drill, so as long as they're catching balls and tracking them, I guess it really doesn't matter if it's me or T and Peyton throwing it to them. I love Peyton. She always tells me, go, 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 go. She wants that thing far to face it down.
What do you got? What do you got?
Throwing pop live. Ready?
Miss Peyton has a wee bit of an arm, huh?
Yeah.
So Saturday, I took them to D-Bat. I wanted them all to get a good look at their swings on video. Most of them are having trouble with transferring their weight. It's called load and explode. They're supposed to be taking about 70% of their weight and putting it on their back leg. And then the power causes their rotate through the hips. Haley can hit. Here's Peyton. Peyton's all tiny. Once she gets that down, she's gold. She can drive the ball too. So I like this drill. We call it our four corners, and it serves for a couple purposes. One, it just kind of gets their feet moving. And then the other, it actually is helping them with the transition from the glove to the hand with the ball and their toss. They're figuring it out. It's been getting better. We just really ran out of room here because the cage was just a little bit small. So we kind of quit this one a little bit early. So Coach Joe was nice enough to pitch for us, and we kind of just had the girls one by one and broke down their swing. Peyton is an awesome player. Like I said, she's all timing, and she can drive the ball. A lot of these girls, too, are funny. They all have their own little quirks, whether it's their elbow, which the elbow's not a huge deal for me, but it sometimes can help them understand we start back. Weight forward. So this is all a process, and a lot of them are just figuring this out. Some of them have never played before. Ella had really quick hands with the zone, actually. She just had everything was out in front. I was trying to show her you're leaning. And if we can just stay back, rotate those hips, chest back, she's gonna be quite the hitter. Yeah, and here's Haley. She told me she's never played, but she's also a jokester, so I'm not sure I completely believe her. And then here with Elise, she was just not rotating those hips at all. So it's something I try to get them to understand, because it's great. She can make contact, and her bat's actually pretty good through the zone. But that right there, those hips are going to drive the ball.
Literally me struggling.
He looks up, grinning like a double S.
Coming in hot!
Save Kelly.
I got out. Going anywhere. Street lights, people. Oh! Trash cans in it. I don't give two F's, era. Oops, skirt. Girls have faith. Maybe the. What obby was it?
Ooh. The obby brand, like,
you do
like the ropes.
Oh god, that would suck. Whoa! Oh my gosh, I was on that playground for my birthday. Dad! We need to paint our house like this. We need to paint our house like that. It's so pretty.
Everybody, Blair, just meet her now.
Oh my gosh. See, girl, I told you you wouldn't get out. Let's go first before you cross the street and they're clear.
Come here.
Right.
So this is the attitude before we go see God. Alright. Alright, where are we going?
Big church.
Big church? Yep. Are you sure?
Yep.
Right. Is it because of this one?
No.
Alright. Okay, I need you to be a really good influence on her, okay?
Hi.
Other side.
Oh, you want to take him? You can go back to the church if you want. You're like,
yeah.
Oh, hey, I forgot my wallet.
Oh,
I wish you had gone.
I wish we
faster.
Just lied where our car was at, and then we keep riding out.
Yeah. And be like, oh wait.
Good job. We just get out of the service, and you're gonna lie.
Hey, that's not what we learned about.
Yeah, come on. Were you listening?
I don't think she was.
Yeah.
Were you?
Yeah.
It's mine.
Get your own. Use ketchup.
Chicken fajitas.
Girl, they only need one.
Why is there only one?
Share your crayons.
Nothing.
I want blue color.
Go, we're gonna share.
What?
Dun dun dun.
My. Nope, give me that.
You're coloring it wrong. Where'd you go?
Can I get the,
me?
They don't have any fish in the Blue Lagoon anymore.
Okay! Stop yelling. She wants a Blue Lagoon too.
And may I have a
Watch these two try to drown each other.
Here, right.
Look at that poor thing. You don't push her head under. You let her come up and breathe. Hey, idiot, quit turning around. All right. good.
Time to film that.
Right onto the side here.
You might want to hold your nose.
Yeah, I think I would
know. What an idiot.
He wasn't holding my leg.
You had him draped around my neck.
Okay.
Wait. You ready?
Yeah!
One, two.
Welcome everyone to the NFL.
Week one, we've been waiting. Boys and girls, let's get ready to gamble!
Remember kids, if you have a hunch, bet a bunch.
That's right.
We'll be starting on Thursday nights. Lions at the Chiefs. The Chiefs are favored by 6.5. I bet that the Chiefs win, but they don't cover.
Chiefs win and they don't cover. Move to Sunday, 10 a.m. 49ers at the Steelers. Brock Purdy and your Steelers favored by 2, or and your Niners favored by 2.5. Niners win and cover. Mm. Yeah.
Then Sunday also at 10 a.m. Bengals at the Browns. Bengals favored by 2.5. I say Bengals win and cover just because they have my beloved husband, Joe Burrow.
All right. We will move to Minnesota. Buccaneers at the Vikings. Buccaneers favored by 6. I'm going to take the Vikings and lay the points.
Cardinals at the Commanders. Washington favored by 7. My rule. Two lousy teams, take the home team.
Agreed.
Commanders by 7.
Agreed. Then we move Jaguars at the Colts. And I believe the spread is 4. Jags win and I'll lay the points.
Fair. Panthers at Falcons. Falcons are favored by 3.5. I say Falcons win and they lay the points.
All right. I like it. We move Texans at the newly paid Lamar Jackson and the Ravens. Ravens favored by a whopping 10 points.
Whoa, guys.
Yeah. I'm going to take the Ravens. They win and cover.
Mm-hmm. Next, we have the Titans at the Saints. The Saints by 3. And again, we're going in with my rule. Two lousy teams, take the home teams. Saints win and cover.
Agreed. We're going to move to your Sunday afternoon bridge game. Dolphins at the Chargers. Chargers by 3. This one was tough. I am going to say the Chargers win, but I will take the points. Dolphins plus 3.
And the Jordan Love era begins. Packers at the Bears. Bears favor by 1. I say the Packers continue their dominance over Chicago.
I agree. Panthers. Packers win?
Yep, Packers.
Then we go to the Who Gives a Crap Bowl. Raiders visit Sean Payton and the Broncos. Denver by 4 at home. I'm going to lay the points. Denver wins and covers.
Then we have the Rams at the Seahawks. Seahawks are favored by 5.5. Seattle has a true home field advantage. I say they lay the points.
All right, I like it. And then the ever-confusing Cowboys at the New York Football Giants. Dallas favored by 3. Always a tough one. I say Dallas wins and covers.
Mm-hmm.
One day they're going to figure it out.
Yep. And then we have the Bills at Aaron Rodgers and the Jets. Bills by 2.5. Shock of the week. Jets win.
I like it. And then we're going to flash back to Sunday at 1:25. The Eagles visit our New England Patriots. Eagles are favored by 4.
Sounds about right.
This is a tough one. I hate to say it. Eagles win and they cover. Hope I'm wrong.
And you lose your one whole dollar.